Hello, I'm Sara Alvarez with Manatee County Parks and Natural Resources. Every winter, we see flocks of birds flying to warmer temperatures like that of Florida. However, how are birds able to fly? Well, they flap their great big wings and to create enough thrust to lift them up into the air, just like an airplane does with its engines. However, not all birds fly in the same way. Birds can have differently shaped wings that help them do many different things.
There are four general wing shapes. Passive soaring wings, or high lift wings, are broad wings with deep feather slots that provide a high lift for takeoff and easy landing. Birds with these types of wings are very good flyers and have high maneuverability. Bald eagles are a great example of passive soaring wings and can fly with great ease. Active soaring wings are long and narrow wings. This type of wing allows birds to use wind currents to soar or fly without flapping their wings for a long period of time, like a seagull gliding over the sea winds. Elliptical wings have a slightly rounder shape. Elliptical wings are great for fast, short bursts of flight and have great maneuverability. This type of wing is great to escape predators as they provide easy takeoff and fast speed. However, they require lots of flapping. A bird with elliptical wings is a sparrow. Sparrows fly in short little bursts to be able to conserve energy. High-speed wings are thin and long, but not as long as active soaring wings. These allow for fast, maintained speeds and are very aerodynamically efficient. A bird with high-speed wings is a falcon. An additional type of wing is hovering wings. These small, quick wings were made to hover or appear to float over an object like a flower. The ruby-throated hummingbird has hovering wings and flaps its wings so fast you can barely see them. Let's try to recreate all these wings ourselves by using paper airplanes. An airplane with passive soaring wings must have very broad wings. Follow along with this video for a step-by-step tutorial on how to fold and complete your paper airplane. Pause or rewind at any point to rewatch each step. And that's our airplane representing our passive soaring wings. To make an airplane that represents our active soaring wings, we need an airplane that is long and narrow. Follow along with the instructions on the video to make your active soaring wings airplane. Thank you. the paper airplane representing the elliptical wings must have a more slightly rounder shape to it. Now this part can be a little challenging. After you're folding your triangle into a diamond, fold the corners of the diamond inward and then downwards to create the creases needed to shape the figure into a peak. After making the peak, lay it flat upwards. For our high-speed wings, our airplane needs to be very aerodynamically friendly. This means it must be very sleek and streamlined. Now that we have made our bird wing shaped paper airplanes, let's see how each one flies. How far do you think each one will go? How long do you think they'll be able to fly? And does it have a good sense of direction? Record all your observations. You can even make your own paper airplanes out of your own imagination and see how it compares to the paper airplanes we have made.
Thank you for joining us to learn more about differently shaped bird wings and how it helps them fly. For more videos and content, check out our Facebook page or our YouTube page at Manatee County Parks and Natural Resources. Until next time!